I'm pleased to announce that the Environmental Protection Agency has awarded Carnegie Mellon a $10 million grant for a new collaborative research center, the Center for Air, Climate, and Energy Solutions. Decisions about energy, like shale gas development, electric car subsidies, power plants of the future, have impacts on both air quality and climate. Making informed decisions requires integrated thinking, much more integrated than what has been done in the past.
The new center will bring together experts to arrive at the best decisions.
We will measure air pollutant concentrations across the country to improve the health of vulnerable populations. We will develop air quality assessment tools for policymakers and average citizens. We will evaluate the impact of future scenarios for electricity, transportation, and urban development.
The ultimate goal is to create a cleaner, healthier environment.
As part of this project, we will be making measurements of air pollutants in three different cities to understand the spatial and temporal differences and what drives those differences between the cities. So we'll be comparing Pittsburgh to Los Angeles to Austin, Texas. What we really want to understand are the mechanisms, the physics and chemistry, that drive differences in spatial distributions between these three cities. We hope to be able to apply that knowledge to different cities, and then also to evaluate a set of next generation models that are being developed in other projects that are part of the center.
Our part of the project is looking into the future, trying to find ways to both improve the quality of the air that we breathe, but also at the same time limit climate change. These two problems have been traditionally treated independently by policymakers. And our hypothesis is that if we look at the different options together, we'll be able to identify win-win scenarios.
Air quality planners use detailed models of air pollution to make many different kinds of decisions about air pollution, decisions about regulations, traffic planning, new energy technologies, and other things. In the center, we'll be making these models more sophisticated than ever. So the first thing that we will be doing is making much higher resolution, finer spatial maps of air pollution, and then using that to assess how people are exposed to air pollution and the health effects that they might suffer. We'll be testing these evaluations also against measurements that we collect as part of the center. One of the things that we need to do as a society over the next several decades is manage the transition to cleaner energy. Cleaner from the sense of public health and air pollution, but also cleaner from the sense of mitigating and preventing climate change. One of the major outcomes of the center will be building tools that are comprehensive in addressing both of these problems simultaneously.